I feel glad to bring forward the story of this freedom fighter of Indian revolutionary movement that had set off early in 1900 in Punjab. He was a patriot to the core, he earned for the glory of Bharata and he wanted to take it to the pinnacle of progress. Even very few people are familiar about him, that is none other than Sufi Amba Prasad. Sufi Amba Prasad was one of the greatest freedom fighter and yet remained forgotten. He was born in Moradabad in 1858. He was Indian nationalist, journalist and pan-Islamic leader. He was notable for his involvement in agrarian unrest in Punjab 1907 and subsequently in the revolutionary movement of Indian independence. Amba Prasad was born without his right hand and he used to say to his friends jokingly that I must have lost my hand before dying while fighting in 1857 war of independence, but when I was born again next year my one hand remained missing. Amba Prasad was frequently visited to his family home and worked with great enthusiasm with Bhagat's uncle Sardar Ajit Singh. When the going got too difficult for both of them in India because there was a wave of apprehension of yet another arrest. So they both escaped to Iran where they continued their work in exile. It is a testimony for the great courage of this revolutionary that despite missing a hand, he engaged in battle with police and served prison sentence. And of course, he contributed greatly to the freedom struggle of with his writing, and it has been said that he trained himself to be able to write with his foot. Amba Prasad, after completion of his schooling, college and law education, he decided to serve his country with his writing in Urdu. He emerged as a freedom promoter in Hindu-Muslim unity, and at the age of 32, he started in Urdu weekly. At the age of 39, he was arrested for his CDTS writing. In 1899, again he got released after serving 2-year prison sentence, and he immediately plunged into exposing the injustice of colonial rule. The empire struck back into a very cruel way and sentencing him 6-year imprisonment and confiscating of his properties. He was subjected to very cruel in prison and he was denied medicine for his illness and frequently taunted by his jailer who would say, "Sufi, you still alive?" He survived lot many hardships and upon his release, he contemptuously turned from colonial ruler who sought to buy a compromise. He joined to a newspaper to earn a livelihood but could last there only for a short time because of the constraints placed on his writings. It was at this stage he happened to meet to Ajit. They immediately took to each other like long-lost brothers. Their collaboration increased in rapid strengthening of anti-colonial work in Punjab. This, in turn, resulted in increased repression and arrests. Prasad, along with his Ajit's younger brother, Sardar Kishan Singh and Bhagat's father, they escaped to Nepal. However, after a while, they were caught back to Lahore. Somehow, they could avoid prison sentences. But Prasad couldn't remain silent. He was very active in bringing out literature for freedom movement and helping the Bharat Mata book written by Ajit. His book, The Rebel Masai, was banned and confiscated. In 1909, he started a newspaper called Peshawar, which had led increased surveillance of his work and activities. When another arrest appeared imminent, he escaped to Iran with Ajit, continued working for the freedom movement. Prasad also involved in national activities. He even started a newspaper while during his exile in Iran, which made it very easier for him to be traced. This led to confrontation in Sirsa, where Prasad faced his attackers with a revolver in his left hand. He fought very bravely but was finally overpowered and imprisoned. He was given a death sentence. He was died in jail. A larger crowd gathered in his last rites in Iran. He had gained a widespread respect in the country. A memorial erected in his honor and still visited by several people. We are very proud of Sufi Amba Prasad's sacrifice, respect, his contribution for Indian freedom fight. And there is so much to learn from freedom fighters. We are so proud of our country and the values they got for all of us. Vande Mataram, Bharat Mata Ki Jai.